Hey children, so today we are going to learn a new lesson, right? You know? Yes, very interesting lesson it is. So how we should behave, how we should do, that we can see in this lesson. We can learn so many things from this. How we are always must be honest, truthful, right? So now see this one. What is this lesson name? Woodcutter and the Golden Axe. Golden Axe, have you seen? No. But have you heard this about this? No. Now I am telling you very interesting one this is. Woodcutter. So first of all, do you know who is woodcutter? Woodcutter, that is who cuts the trees and who prepares our doors and benches, tables, all these things, beds and all these things, right? So, and the golden axe. So, to cut the trees means they use axe, right? But golden axe it is. So, how is it? What is this? We can say this. But first, there is an old saying that we should always tell the truth because that way we don't have to remember what we said. So, always if we say truth. So, is it necessary to remember what I said at the time, what I said this time, like that? Is it necessary? If you tell any lie, then at that time what I tell, that is only same should repeat, like that. But already truth means no problem at all, that is only always you repeat, right? And honesty is the best policy because no matter how good you are at telling lies, and the truth all always come out. So, no matter how good you are at telling lies. So, honesty is the best policy. First and foremost, honesty is the best policy. We should follow the best policy, honesty. So, even if you try to say any lies also, the truth will always come out. Sometimes if you say lies also at last, truth will come out. Then we should be shame on us, right? That's why always we should speak truth, right? Now, see this one. It's a time to do, see the lesson. So, one day, a poor woodcutter was cutting a large tree in the bank of a river when his axe slipped and fell into the water. So, see that here, one day, a poor woodcutter was cutting a large tree. So, tree, if we cut it, how feel it is, right? So, it is trying to cut it. He is trying to cut it. Where is the tree? It is on the bank of a river. Bank of a river means any bank is there. A river side place, we call it bank. Bank of a river, right? When his axe slipped and fell into the water. So, while he was trying to cut it very fast, suddenly his axe fell into the water. Oh, what can we do? Can we get into the water? Does he know swimming? Let's see. So, as the river was very deep, the poor woodcutter was not able to get it back, although he tried very hard. So, he can swim. But deep river it is. Deep river means can we get into the water that much of deep? No. So, as the river was very deep, the poor woodcutter was not able to get it back, although he tried very hard, very difficulty. Maximum he tried but getting to that part, he couldn't find his axe. So he knelt down and prayed that he might get his axe back. So he knelt down, see that. Knelt down means sitting on the knees. So knelt down and started to pray that he might get his back. So, oh God, please help me. How can I get my axe? Otherwise, I cannot do any work. I have only one axe. Like that, he started to cry there. And according to a popular folk tale, river goddess heard his prayer and appeared in front of him. What is the matter, my good man? She asked. So, according to popular folk tales, popular means very famous. So, folk tales means once upon a time, they are telling some stories. It's happened like that. Even our rishis, our monks, like that, when they went to the forest and when they do tapasu like that, yes, when they prayed, the God visits them and the God gave the offers to them, yes, what do you want? Like this, so many stories we have seen in Ramayana, Mahabharata, in so many ways, right? The same way here, yes, the river goddess heard this one. So this man knelt down and he started to cry out and he prayed to God. So river goddess heard his prayer and appeared in front of him. So river god came there. And river goddess, she asked, river goddess, goddess means girl, right? Yes. So what is the matter, my good man, she asked. So that goddess asked, what's the matter, my good man, you are looking very good. So what's the matter? Yes. Oh, help me, said the woodcutter. I am a poor man and I have lost my axe. I shall starve if I don't get my axe back to carry on my work. So, oh, please help me. I am a poor man, so I have no money, nothing at all. And I have lost my axe. Whatever I have, that axe also, I lost it now. And I shall starve. Starve means lack of food. Starve means hungry food. No food to fill their stomach. So, if I don't get my axe back to carry on my work, suppose if I don't get axe and if I don't do the work, I never get any money or food. So I'll starve to death. So without eating food, I may die. So please help me, that he said. So very well, answered goddess, and you shall have your axe back. So very well, no problem at all. I will help you. That our goddess promised, and yes, you shall have your axe back. Definitely, you will get your axe back. That goddess blessed him. So she dived into the river and brought up an axe of gold. So she dived into the river, get into the river, deep of the river. And within a fraction of a second, she came with an axe of gold. Golden axe she brought it. Is that your axe? My good man, she asked. So the goddess, by showing the golden axe, yes, is that yours, my dear good man? That she asked. So for that, no, golden means normal wood one, he lost it. Golden means now he can get it, na? But no, answered the woodcutter, but he is very honest man. No, he said, and that is not my axe. So again, the goddess died again. So dived again. Again the goddess got into the axe. And this time she brought up an axe of silver. But again the woodcutter answered that it was not his axe. And this time she brought up an axe of silver. First she brought the gold. He said no. Now she brought a silver axe. So again the woodcutter answered that it was not his axe. No. This is also not of my axe. That he said. So third time the goddess dived into the water and brought up an axe which the woodcutter had lost. So whatever he slipped, he fell, lost that one in the water. That only she brought it and then showed. So by showing that, thank you very much, answered the woodcutter. This is my own axe. So it's a normal wooden axe it is. So when the goddess showed, yes, this is only my axe, ma'am. Axe, my dear goddess. Thank you very much, that he said. And river goddess was very pleased with the man and said, you are an honest man and you shall be rewarded. So the goddess was very pleased, impressed with his answer. Then immediately he said, you are an honest man and you shall be rewarded. You are a very honest man. So in that time also he didn't say any wrong. So that's why. Some reward. Reward means something, awards I should give. So what is that? Take this access of gold and silver as a gift from me. So reward. Reward means presents or gifts to give it. So now take this also. That's access of gold, silver and as a gift from me. So she brought first gold one, silver one like that. No? Yes, take these two also. These I am giving. Awards, that is a gift to you. So take three axes, that is one is yours and I am giving gold and silver axe also. Like that, the goddess pleased, impressed with him and she has given remaining two axes also. So if you are honest, always we get good things only. Right?